Five investigates with new data that reveals how much we're moving around during the pandemic. Mike Baudette spoke with experts about what the data means
and how we can avoid the resurgence of COVID cases happening in other parts of the country.
The data comes from our cell phones, and it's allowing researchers to see how far we're traveling. It's one measurement officials are looking at as they evaluate the impact of reopening on public health.
Phase three means Massachusetts is back in business, from dining inside restaurants to working out in gyms. Pandemic life is looking and feeling a little bit more normal. And as we move around more, our cell phones are providing researchers with information about how far we are traveling.
Mobility indicators are useful because they provide kind of real-time insights into human behavior.
Dr. Caroline Buckey is an epidemiologist at the Harvard T.H. Chan School of Public Health, who's using cell phone data to study how population movements impact the spread of COVID-19.
I think that there's no question that as we continue to reopen and people move around more freely, we are going to expect that the risk of resurgence remains very real.
Five Investigates did our own analysis of cell phone mobility data. Massachusetts shut down in mid-March with mobility dropping to almost zero. The data shows that our mobility has been slowly and steadily increasing during the reopening phases. In eastern Massachusetts, people in more rural Plymouth County moved more than in Suffolk County, but overall, we are still moving around less than we were before the shutdown.
In Massachusetts, the epidemic is relatively under control, but we have these joint risks of continuing to reopen and social mixing within Massachusetts, as well as these increased risks of people bringing the virus in from outside.
We compared mobility data in Massachusetts with two states hit hard by the virus now, Texas and Florida. Mid-March, mobility dropped in all three states, just more so here. By mid-April, Massachusetts still had a stay-at-home advisory in effect, while people in Florida and Texas were on the move. We began a slow, steady climb in May, but traveling much less than people in the other two states.
In other parts of the country, the mobility upticks that we've seen have indeed occurred with transmission resurgence. And so that's something that we really need to be aware of.
Even though the country as a whole is traveling more, not all places are increasing with infection rates at the same time. So that's where the correlation becomes not as strong to me from a scientific standpoint. And that just suggests that other things are driving the COVID-19 infection rate.
Dr. Carl Mingus at the University of New Haven says people in the Northeast are more vigilant about wearing masks and social distancing. And that has a real impact on public health.
A lot of these other states reopened extremely quickly and people didn't get used to wearing masks. They did not get used to social distancing. It became a political thing. Here in the Northeast, there was less of that because we saw our friends, our neighbors, our relatives getting sick or even dying from this awful virus. And so our behavior sort of changed in a different way, perhaps, than it had other places.
There are privacy concerns about tracking cell phone data, but until there's a vaccine, researchers say it's an important tool to help them better understand what people are doing and how that's impacting the spread of the virus here in Massachusetts and across the country. Mike Baudette, Five Investigates.